What's up guys, today we've got the Baofeng UV-5R. This is going to be an unboxing and a quick test. So it's going to be a quick video because I've got two more devices coming in. One is the Baofeng, the newer version, which is the Baofeng UV-5R Edge Pro. And then we've got also a quansheng these names are very confusing. Quansheng UV-K58. So this is going to be a quick video about this little guy here. Let's get to it. Before we go and actually open it, just a quick note. Depending on where you buy the box from or you buy the device from, you might get additional or different items in the box. I've obviously opened it before, but we're just going to simulate an unboxing experience. So you get the device, which we're going to look at in a second. You get one of these strings, you know, one of these things to clip on to the device so you can, you know, have a place to hold it with. And then you get a clip that's, you screw it to the back of your device. So you unscrew these and then you attach this and you screw it back. And then you get the antenna. The weird thing about the antenna is it's a female. Normally antennas are actually males, and then the port on the device are usually females. In this case, it's the opposite. And then you get, obviously you get the manual, and then you get the power brick with the charging station. And then the last piece here is the headset, which is, you know, it's one of those old school headsets that you get to clip behind your ear. And the cool thing about it actually is you can use it to transmit. So when you click here, when you click this button here, actually, you will see that it actually, it's the equivalent of push to talk. And it's surprisingly comfortable. I mean, it's not, although it's not the best build in the world, it actually does what it's supposed to do. Okay, so now the device itself. First impression is that it's built really well. For $25, it feels premium. I mean, for $25, you'd think that you get one of these toy devices that just falls apart after a few weeks of use. This is built really, really, really well. I'm impressed. I think the best, it's very difficult because, you know, you see videos and then you hear people say this, but once you actually hold it in your hand, you will know what I'm talking about. And also, for whatever reason, it just looks a lot bigger in the pictures. It's actually really small. I mean, if you have got big hands like me, you can cover it, you know, in the palm of your hand. So it's a lot smaller than it actually looks on the videos or in the photos. So to get started, you turn on the volume button, which also doubles as volume button. Once you click it, you will see in the screen here, there's two numbers. We'll just quickly explain them. You can tune in the device to actually listen into two different signals. You will see here A and B. So once you click A, it moves, you know, you'll see the arrow here moves down. You click again and it moves there. So the idea is that you will be able to listen in onto or scan for two different signals, hence why the name dual band. And then you can program them to be, you know, at two different signals. And then this is the band button. Basically, it has two bands, not to be confused with the scanning for frequency. This just means that there are two different bands. One is 136 to 174, and the other one is 400 to 480. And then you have push to talk here. Once you click it, you'll see that it turns orange. So when you basically receiving, you'll receive, once it starts receiving, you'll see that this light here starts or turns solid green.
Yes, Leda Pilot. Please, Captain, ask mooring operations. How many prepare our mooring line?
And then on the screen itself, it's blue. If you click push to talk, basically when you're transmitting, it turns orange. This is a key for, or a button for the light. One click turns a small LED light. Nothing to be impressed about, but you know, it's helpful. It can be helpful. Double press again and it starts blinking. On the other side, this is where your headset goes, as well as the programming cable, which doesn't come, as I said earlier in the video, it's not included in the box. So that's it. There you have it. So that's it, guys. This is the UV-5R. It's an older model. This is about 12 years old. It was released back in 2012. Since I have two more newer devices coming in, I thought I'll make this video quick and then spend more energy on those devices. There's still some value in buying this, as it can still be used as a walkie-talkie and it's relatively easy to operate. And it's very cheap. It's about $25. So let me know if you have any questions, if there's anything you'd like me to answer. I'll be happy to if I can. Thank you so much for watching, guys, and I'll catch you in the next video.